Hi, welcome to Jabbing with Mimi. And today we're just going to talk about some practical, you know, applications of the laws of mind in your everyday life. You know, so just giving you a few that are coming from me and, you know, some others that have shared their experiences with me. You know, and there was a video about a lady who just forgave the company for sending her the phone she didn't want, and then she ended up getting the phone she did want, you know, and it's things like that. You know, you just start incorporating it into your life. So I have two stores I go grocery shopping at. Okay. One store is very close to my house, and the other store is, you know, it's about a couple of miles away. So I will go to the store a couple of miles away. It's called HEB here in Texas. And HEB will sell different kinds of beef, choice, you know, and prime, all the way to prime. And they lay them out next to each other. You can go look at them. There's no difference, okay? There's no difference between prime and choice. The only difference is how you treat them, okay? That's it. Beef is beef, okay? Where you got it off the cow determines how tender or how much fat is in it or how much muscle is in it. But beef is beef, okay? It's beef. And you can't really see a difference. They'll even tell you stuff is Wagyu and there's hardly any fat marbling in there. And, you know, that's all Wagyu is. So no, don't tell me that. That's some cow that hadn't moved an inch. How the cow was treated. Okay. This is the only difference. And, you know, frankly, there's no difference between a prime and a choice other than which one ate corn for 3 weeks instead of 2 weeks. I can deal with it. And you can look at them and see it didn't really eat corn for longer. There's not any more fat in the prime than there is in the choice that you're offering me at the grocery store. Okay. So, you know, understanding that beef is beef, you know, it doesn't matter. I will buy the choice. And, you know, I can get a prime rib roast for $3.98 a pound versus the prime, which was going for, you know, $13.98 a pound. Y'all go ahead. No, that's ridiculous. I don't think so. You're being silly. You're being silly. Think about it. Beef is beef. It's the same thing with sugar. Sugar, sugar. Salt, salt. It's how you treat it. Do you want the bigger crystals, the kosher salt? It's not better than the table salt. Table salt is just finer. Okay. Same thing with sugar. You know, it's how it's being treated. When you strip all the molasses out, you're left with basically granulated light brown sugar. And then they bleach it, make it white. You know, okay, who cares? Sugar, sugar. You know, you can do the brown sugar that still has some of that molasses in it. You can do, you know, any way you want. Doesn't matter. One's not better than another. It all comes from the same place. This just happens to be the products of the sugar cane. You know, and they even sell you sugar cane if you want to do that. No thanks, but, you know, it's me. Some people want to do that. So, you know, it's understanding things like that. So, soap is a good one, you know. Soapy soap, come on, man. You know, pick the one you like. You know, I don't like it real jelly and I don't like it real liquidy. I like it in between. So Ajax or palm olive or, you know, those kind of things work for me. Will I try others? Yeah. I do it all the time, you know, to see if I'll like it better. But I'm not. I usually end up going right back to the one I like, which is Dawn and, you know, palm olive and stuff like that. And then, you know, who cares? Just get what you like. Now, again, this comes back to things like, you know, toilet paper and paper towels. Get the one you like, all right? For me personally, it's paper, okay? It needs to absorb. It needs to have certain characteristics that it does well. I go to the store by my house where the paper products there are just as good. They're the store brand paper products as any name brand paper product. They do the same thing and they're less. And I'm not being cheap. I'm spending my money wisely and constructively. You know, it's paper. Now, what have they done with the paper? You know, that's when you start checking, well, they're all 2-ply, yeah. You know, on the toilet paper, yeah. And this one has this many feet, which is pretty much the same as this one, maybe a foot more, maybe a foot less, you know. And then you decide, yeah, that's worth it. That's not. And then another one is like that I do a lot when I want filet mignon, you know, I'll just say it, you know, I know I'm going to get filet mignon here for, you know, under $5 a pound. And my husband's like, you know, no, you're not. The first few times I did it out loud like that. And I said, yes, I will. They do it all the time. I'm gonna get a, they call them a tea pound, but they're not a tea pound. It's porterhouse. I know my steaks. And they cut them thick, you know. Bam, buy four of those. We got four filet mignons for one dinner, and then we got four New York strips for another dinner. You know, and we'll take two New York strips and make a, you know, something like stir fry that we'll have for a couple of nights. It's enough for two meals, you know, and we do just one meal out of each one, whatever. But we'll end up with five meals, and one of them is filet mignon. And I got it for under $5 a pound, didn't I? Yep, I sure did. It was $4.99 a pound. You know, and I've been saying this forever. You know, Fiesta, they put those T-bones on steak, that's porterhouse. Go get me some filet mignon. You know, and then there it is. That's a story in Fiesta. So, you know, you go in thinking the best, or, you know, you've made judgments that this store is the best for this, and this store is the best for this. And I will get most of my stuff here because it's the best price for everything, you know, but once in a while, you know, the store that's closest to my house has this or this or this, you know, and people will ask me, why don't you just make it so it's all like that, because they have their own little flavors. Fiesta is mainly pointed toward people who don't make a lot of money. And so I'll run in there to get produce like limes or potatoes or stuff like that. Because if you, you know, spices, then you can buy bulk spices. You can buy bulk rice or bulk beans there. So if you want to get 5 pounds of rice or something like that, you know, it's bulk. You're scooping it yourself and putting it in the bag yourself. And you're seeing what you're getting. If you like that, I like that. They have beans like that. I don't care for that. I usually get the Camilla beans if I'm going to get red beans. You know, it's things like that. You have things that you love and you like, And they carry those things. The red beans, they don't carry them at the HEB, the ones I like. You know, I've asked, of course, and, you know, that's just not their demographic. They're not going to do it. So they do other things, you know, but it's not going to be that. So I have this one store I go to get certain items, and the other store I get other items. For example, I don't buy chicken at Fiesta because they never have it for under $1.30. Yeah, I'm sorry, I'm not paying that. 99 cents, that's it. You'll get 99 cents a pound out of me. And I get that at Fiesta all the time. Chicken thighs, and can get chicken, a whole chicken, lots of times, usually at least once a month. They have, you know, chicken breasts for 99 cents a pound. You know, and you just get them and then go home and prep them. You know, and I like for breasts, you know, because Julia Child was always imagining 6-pound chickens, and now we have them. You know, you just debone the chicken yourself, take the tender out, you know, you get enough tenders, now you have a meal of tenders. And then, you know, the breasts are so big, you're not even missing that tender. And go make whatever it is you want to make when you want to use a chicken breast, you know. And it's things like that. You love something. So I love cooking, you know, and I do love shopping for food, and I love shopping for, you know, things like that, stuff in the house or the, you know. And there's, you get a flavor for all the little stores around you because you love shopping, you know, and you always want to go check out the new shop. You know, and doesn't mean you're necessarily going to buy something there, but, you know, you're adding that to your repertoire, to your information, you know. And if you just say, you know, I know I'm going to find the perfect house, you will. But you start looking for it. You know, I know I'm going to find it. It doesn't matter if you can't afford it. Okay. This is where the being like a little kid is, it comes into play. I know it's, you know, I'm going to buy a house. No. Then you go, and I'm going to pay, you know, cash. Cash is king. You know, there's always a surplus, so I'm going to pay cash. You just go start looking for it, you know, and the perfect one will come to you. And you just start saying, you know, you'll be looking at houses you're building in your mind. You know, I really like that. I really like that a lot, you know. Only I wish it had, you know, I wish it was log cabin style, or I wish it was, you know, Victorian style with a great big wraparound. You know, I don't want stairs. I just want a one story. I don't want stairs. No kids on the stairs. No. So it's, you know, in your everyday life, in your thinking. That's why you're in the desert putting these things around your, wrapping them around your mind. This is governing my life, you know, whether I like it or not. There's only one consciousness. He sits in our hearts. He sits in everyone's hearts. And when we say, I am, we are calling him. We're using him. We're saying him. Everything we think, Rita thinks, is wrapped around that heart, and he's presenting it. Rita thinks she's in the year 2021. You know, it's Rita who thinks there's, you know, been this, that, or the other going on. And it's a collective. Okay, everyone born in this time and space is told that story, and you're doing this story all together. So it's all perfect. It's all perfect. And in God's mind, everybody's having fun and a good time, and it's wonderful. That's all he knows. It's all good. It's all perfect. It's lovely. It's wonderful. It's imagination that comes and pulls from the storehouse of God. What do you want to know? He's infinite intelligence. He gives you your intelligence. He guides you to the right books. He guides you to the right shows. He guides you to the music. Listen, God is always talking to you. He's guiding you. You know, listen, don't argue. And we do. Okay. We argue with ourselves. And it's more like, you know, well, that's interesting. Look at that, you know. And then later in a mundane task, you know, that makes a lot of sense. I could do that, you know. And you're always getting answers. You're always being provided for. You are a perfect expression of God, of his personality. Okay? Perfect. You're perfect. And start accepting that. You're perfect. You know, humans are not perfect. Human beings are. They just forgot. That's all. You know, so it's about having, I know, you know, it's confidence. I know that's done. I know that's paid for. I don't think so. My sweet Jesus took care of that. And this is what the Bible gets into. Naming your imagination as your significant other, as your spouse. Okay, so Abraham and Sarah, right? It's their spouses, Jacob and Rachel. It's their spouses. You know, they're the two parts of the whole. And imagination, it is married to God. God provides all. You know, I don't think so. So you imagine him. Yeah, Jesus provides all. I know you took care of that. Thank you, Father. You know, because you know it came from the Father. But you left it with the Christ. Okay? And you're the Christ. You're one of many. So in my mind, I like to say, my sweet Jesus, my sweetie. And, you know, the Christ is the one and all. You know, so just as when I say God, I mean the one and all. You know, I am. So it's how you define it in your mind. God is in your heart. This is where your I am comes from. This is where the breath of life comes from. This is the word come to life. Okay. And he speaks through you. When you speak, you create. Be aware of what you're doing. You know, have confidence. Be like a little kid. No, I know that's taken care of. Thank you. I'm not worried about that. Because my Jesus is the greatest and he's so awesome and took care of that. Thank you, Father. God's storehouses and riches are available to me instantly. Yeah, I know. So, later. And in your everyday life, you know, what do you want? Well, you know, you start saying, you know, I'm exercising my right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of my happiness. You know, I know God's storehouse of riches is available to me instantly. The Father and I are one. Because most people are not snapping, you know. And you have to come to this realization yourself. The mind of God is inside you. Okay? He split himself in two and gave you his imagination. And it became the human imagination when he went inside you, into your heart and subjugated himself to you. That's the mind of God, the one in your heart and your imagination. And you have consciousness that it obeys first. Okay? You have to tell it, no, you obey this one. And you have to think like this one if you want it all to be, you know, perfect. And you only want it to all be perfect after you've had enough sucky in life and you just don't like it anymore. And I think most of humanity has reached that point. And the powers that be are about to figure that out. And, you know, they're starting to back up. Too late, buddy boy. You know, that's a humanity thing. We're coming to kick your ass. You woke up the tiger. You know, we tried, we forgave, and you just got worse, didn't you? No, that's enough. everyone's forgiven. This is forgotten. We're not playing this game anymore. All right? Whatever it takes. You need to go. You're not erring on the side of love. You know? And this is that thin veil. Are you going to love yourself, the one in your heart? Or are you going to love yourself, the one in your head? Be happy to be alive. What does the one in the heart give you? Everything. Everything. It gives you life. You can breathe. You can see. You can hear. You can touch. You can feel. You can taste. You can smell. And it's all gone. You know, God is the sweetest of sweet perfumes. He's amazing. You know, he made this special person just for you. And they love you. They love you, you know. And you love them. And it doesn't matter what's going on in the world. You'll love them. And you're never going to stop loving them. You're never going to stop loving life. You're never going to stop loving God. Because it's sweet. It's sweet. Even when all hell's breaking, it doesn't matter. I got my life. I'm alive. You know, what would it be like without me? Go watch It's a Wonderful Life. If you do nothing else, watch those last 10 or 15 minutes. You know, and see George Bailey come back to life after being removed from existence. You have no idea. All the people you touched, with a smile, with a donation, with a hug, with a kiss. No idea. So you're to enjoy life and love it and express it and be interested in stuff. He'll give you all the answers, whatever you want to know. So I hope this helps. Blessings to you. And thank you. Thank you for being you.
In the summertime, when the weather is high, you can stretch right up and touch the sky. When the weather's fine, you got women on your mind. Have a drink, have a drive, go out and see what you can find. If a daddy's rich, take her out for a meal. If a daddy's poor, just do what you feel. Speed along the lane, you a town or a turn of 25. When the sun goes down, you can make it good and live by. When I grab people, when I daddy, when I mean, we love everybody, but we do as we please. When the weather's fine, we go fishing or go sailing in the sea. We're always happy, life's for living, yeah, that's our philosophy. Sing along with us, dear.